know, canyons are created over centuries by rivers, and you become valleys or canyons. So this is a set about valleys and rivers, and by implication, I guess, about canyons. This arrangement of Shenandoah, I kept fiddling with it, and so the parts of it are left a little unfamiliar to me, because I wasn't happy with it. I'm happy with it now, but I don't think I play it very well yet. But it's a beautiful haunting American tune.
Thank you.
Did my name been in a music box, maybe?
Yes.
It wound down. The last shoe never dropped. Okay, At the River, this is another Copland piece, Aaron Copland. It's an old American hymn by Robert Lowry. We sing it in my church every All Saints Day. It's a great hymn about reuniting with the saints at the river that flows in front of God. So you'll hear Nancy's Copland arrangement. Then I have a goofy takeoff on it. It's got every tacky musical cliche in the book in it. That's fun.
Need to feel.
suppose he took them after them?
This piece, this piece by Glenn Burley, who was a real close friend of mine, he wrote a cycle of four spirituals that he arranged, and we were supposed to have met in Memphis to put them on CD and all of that in January of that year, and in December he passed away. So we didn't get a chance, but this piece he wrote, he said he wrote specifically for me and my voice. So I thought I would be interested.
Thank you. 27.
Big 7-0.
If you want.
No,
thanks.
was the court jester in Mantua, Italy, and the Duke, who was his employer, is a handsome man who makes, he's a womanizer though, and he seduces Rigoletto's beautiful teenage daughter, Gilda, and when Rigoletto finds out about it, he hires an assassin to kill the Duke. But because Gilda has so completely fallen in love with the Duke, even though he's cast her aside, she dresses like the Duke, and the assassin kills her, thinking he's the Duke. So this is the scene at the end of the opera where Rigoletto goes to find the body, which is in a bag, by a river, I think, and he's gonna gloat over the fact that he's killed this evil man. And he opens the bag and finds his daughter, who's just about to die. So there's this emotional final scene. And she says, I will be praying for you up there with the angels.
Yeah.
Thank you all for being here with us. That means so much to me and to us as performers. And I want to say some thank yous, and I hope I don't leave anybody out. I want to thank the staff of the Pearl Museum, Ani Boyajian, Calvin Cobb, Clara Lewis, Emily Guerra, Kayla Osby, and Shannon Jacobs. If I left someone, I apologize. Sue Larkott, I know you're out there doing something. And we're going to leave you with God Bless America, and I hope you all have a blessed week. And thank you again. Thank you.